You've learned how to do general patient assessment. What we need to do now is talk about the specific problems that you're going to find and how to assess and manage those. We're going to start out with orthopedic injuries, which include sprains, strains, fractures, and dislocations. There's a lot of ways that you can go about assessing these injuries. What I'm going to do for you is try to lay it out in an orderly pattern so that you can use this method to decide whether you have a sprain, a strain, a fracture, or a dislocation. And you may say, why is it important to differentiate between them? Because ultimately, at the end of the day, we treat them relatively the same. We want to be able to say, I think this is a sprain or a strain versus a fracture dislocation. Because with a fracture or a dislocation, you're most likely going to be getting this patient out of the woods. Whether it's rapidly or over a couple of days, you're still going to be taking them out. If it's a sprain or a strain, you may actually be able to treat them in the woods and continue your trip, depending on the extent of that injury. If I can't differentiate, then I need to treat all of them as if they were worst case scenario. Let's start with sprains. We have to think about what we sprain. We sprain ligaments. Now, ligaments hold bone to bone. They connect two bones together. What that means is you're going to find ligaments at the joint space. They're going to span a joint, connecting those bones together. The ones most people can think about when we think about ligaments are the ligaments in the knee. You have your ACL, your MCL, your PCL, your LCL. Those are all ligaments. And if you're feeling around your knee right now, you'll notice that these ligaments go around the joint. They surround it. What that means is they provide stability to that joint area. This is going to be really important later on when we think about how to manage this problem. So ligaments are found at the joint. And they provide stability. Write that down. They provide stability to the joint. Now, when we think about pain that's associated with orthopedic injuries, there's a lot of different types of pain that you might have. But when it comes to these types, we use two words to describe the kind of pain that we have. We have pinpoint pain. Pinpoint pain means that the pain is in one area. You can point to it. It might hurt around that, but if I asked you where does it hurt the most, you would point to one spot. The other one is generalized or global pain. This is where the pain is over a whole surface area. It doesn't hurt just in one spot, but that pain is all around. The pain that's associated typically with sprains is that generalized or global pain. Again, it doesn't mean that it's not going to hurt in a specific spot, but that spot's going to be bigger than pinpoint pain. We'll go back through and I'll show you how to use this chart in a second, but we're going to continue through and fill it all out. Let's talk about strains. What do we strain? Well, we strain tendons and muscles. What do muscles do? Muscles provide mobility, right? They allow us to move our bones back and forth. We find them between the joint spaces. If you think about joints as your base camp, we can use that to map out the rest of these areas. So we find muscles between the joints. They provide mobility. Where do we find tendons? Well, tendons are the ends of your muscles. Tendons grab onto your muscles and attach it into the bone so that you can then move that bone. When we think about tendons, one of the ones that most people think about is your Achilles tendon. So if you were to feel down your calf right now, you would keep going down and down and down, and eventually you would come to the Achilles tendon. Now the Achilles tendon, you'll notice, is really sinewy. You can pluck it almost like a guitar string. Anytime you find those, there's some in your elbow that you can locate, in your wrist, they're all over. And you feel those things that feel like guitar strings, those are tendons. And again, tendons attach muscle to the bone, allowing you to then move that bone. So where sprains with ligaments provide stability of a joint, think about strains with tendons and muscles as your ability to move around. If I have an injury to those, I'm going to have a lack of mobility. Just like with a sprain, if I have an injury to a ligament, I'm going to have instability in the joint. These are found between joints, as I mentioned. To find that tendon, though, you really need to feel down the muscle. If you're inspecting for a strain and you're looking for a tendon, start on the muscle, feel down the muscle, and you'll find that tendon. Now let's go to the pain. Again, we have pinpoint pain or generalized pain. These ones tend to have generalized pain as well. Think about going for a run. If you head out for a 10-mile run and you get back, you don't say, my leg hurts here. You say, oh, my leg hurts. My muscles are sore. That's the way to think about generalized pain. Again, it doesn't mean that it can't be excruciating pain, but they tend to be generalized pain. Now we have fractures. We fracture bone. There are lots of bones in your body and they all have names. It's really fun to learn all the names of the bones in your body. We're not going to do that right now because you don't need to know them. But we have to understand that we fracture bones. That's important when we get to dislocations because there's a difference. So we fracture bones. Now what do bones do? Bones provide stability, structure. Understand that, because if I have a fracture, I have the potential of losing that structure, losing that stability. That's going to be one of our diagnostic tools. If I have a lack of structure, I'm thinking perhaps of a fracture. So we fracture bones. Now it may seem silly, but we're going to use joints again as our base camp. And if I use joints, I think about where are those bones found. Bones are found between joints. That helps me assess. If I'm assessing a forearm for a potential fracture, I'm going from the joint to the joint. Now, what kind of pain is associated with fractures? These tend to be pinpoint pain. These ones, if I were to ask you where does it hurt, patients will often say it hurts here, or right here. Again, there's going to be pain around the area, but they tend to have pain in one specific spot that is the worst pain. That helps me diagnose this as a fracture. Now we come to dislocations. Dislocations are pretty easy to diagnose. We dislocate joints. Now you may have heard the term somebody fractured their ankle or fractured their wrist or fractured their elbow. Well, that's all true in a sense. It's actually not scientifically true because the ankle, the elbow, the wrist, those are all names for joints. In the medical world, we tell you you fractured your ankle because it's easier to understand than listing off the bones that are in there, telling you something like you fractured the distal end of the epicondyle plate of your tibia. Most people would hear that and say, you think I have cancer? So we tell you you fractured your ankle. When we dislocate joints, the way that they're diagnosed is simply looking at them. A dislocation is going to look weird. The nice thing about the human body is it's symmetrical. You can compare one to the other. If someone is complaining of shoulder pain on the left, you can look at the left and the right, and they should look the same. If they don't, probably a dislocation. A joint that is dislocated is going to look weird. So let's put this up on the board. We dislocate joints, and they are weird looking. It's as simple as that. We do have one slight complicating factor. Can I have weird-looking fractures? Absolutely. You can have a fracture that is pointing in the wrong direction. Someone can fracture their arm and now it's bent at a 90-degree angle. So how do I differentiate between a weird-looking fracture and a weird-looking dislocation? Well, the first thing you use is location. A dislocation is going to be where? At the joint. And a fracture is going to be between the joints. But sometimes it's not that obvious. Sometimes you have a fracture that's really close to a joint, or you have a lot of swelling and bruising, and it's really hard to tell. So we can use another thing. A dislocation is going to be weird looking and rigid. that dislocation is going to be held in place. And that's because the muscles around it are spasming down. They're trying to lock that thing in. They don't like where it is. Whereas a fracture is going to be weird looking and floppy because we've lost the structure. So another way for you to differentiate between weird looking fractures and weird looking dislocations. So how do we use this chart? What are you going to do? Well, when you do your assessment and you think a patient has one of these injuries, you're now going to do a detailed exam. You're going to go to the body part and you're going to start squeezing and squishing. This can be hard to do. People who get into medicine for the first time have a hard time squishing on injuries. They're afraid of causing pain. They're afraid of making it worse. You can't make it worse. Yes, it's going to hurt the patient, but we need to do this. Remember, you don't have x-ray. You don't have imaging out there. If I don't get my hands on, I'm not going to be able to find the injury. So we have to do a really good detailed exam. Make sure that you get your hands on. What you're going to do is look at this chart. You're going to do your exam and work this chart from the bottom up. I have generalized pain at the injury site. So I'm up here somewhere. Is it at the joint? Do I have joint laxity, mobility in that joint in a direction it's not supposed to move? Generalized pain at a joint with some laxity, probably a ligament, most likely a sprain. Generalized pain between the joints with some movement problems, because again, tendons and muscles allow us to move, probably a strain. Fractures, pinpoint pain between the joints, that's a bone, most likely a fracture. Weird looking at a joint, dislocation. And again, a weird looking fracture is going to be floppy. A weird-looking dislocation is going to be rigid.